imagine not understanding that in the end time? Can we imagine not really grasping what God is telling us in this very end time? And do we see how vital it is that we understand? And again, why don't we hear more about it? Why? Well, I'll tell you, it gets even worse. Notice verse 11. And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spoke as a dragon. He had two horns like a lamb, and he spoke as a dragon. Now, you see, he looks like a lamb. On the surface, it looks like a church following Christ. On the surface. But you better look a little closer. You'd better look closer because it speaks like the dragon. Because it worships the dragon. And it has the message of the dragon. And oh, how deceived this world is. How very, very deceived they are. You see, again, how can people be so deceived? How can you be so deceived that you think you're following God and you're worshiping the devil? I mean, that's what your Bible says, and maybe some people don't like to hear it, but are we ashamed of Christ? Are we afraid to hear Christ's message, what He has to tell us? And I'll tell you, this church guides that beast. You can see the last seven heads are guided by this beast. And if you look at verse 7, you can see that all of God's lukewarm people, His own church, His own lukewarm, rebellious people are going to be killed by this monster. Every single one of them, as they worship the dragon, thinking they're worshiping God, and actually kill the very people of God, though lukewarm. And in verses 13 and 14, talks about all kinds of miracles that are going to occur. I mean, this beast is going to perform miracles. And these two leaders are going to, certainly the religious leader is going to perform miracles. And people are going to believe it's of God, and it isn't going to be of God. Now, they're going to be miracles that have a lot of deceit in them, but nevertheless, God labels them as miracles. Notice verse 15 and 16. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. And he causes all, this religious leader in this church, causes all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. You see, the church causes all this, and it causes the people to receive a mark. Now that mark is, again, you need this little booklet to explain that to you. Who or what is the prophetic beast? You really need that because it will show you that this mark revolves around the day you worship God. It involves the Ten Commandments because, well, it is one of the Ten Commandments as far as God's day. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. It is part of the Ten Commandments. And James says, look, if you break one of the Ten Commandments, you break them all. So it is about the Ten Commandments. But you need to think about this because in the Middle Ages, I'm telling you, that beast destroyed some 50 million people. That's in the Middle Ages. And God says, well, that's not that time, and the destruction there is going to be, well, just a picnic compared to what's coming. It's going to be worse. It is going to be worse than anything we've ever seen on this earth. And it's coming in this very end time, the time that we're living in right now. Now, that's something that we need to give a lot of thought to and, frankly, a lot of prayer, because this is so important to your life. What could really be more important? All these people that end up getting killed or hurt or whatever do so because they don't have God's protection. They don't believe God. And those people who do believe God, God says He's going to protect from all of this, that they're not going to have to worry about that little remnant that the Bible talks about so often, the little remnant that God says He will protect if they will come out of this world, come out of Babylon, come out of this world and keep the commandments of God and keep God's Sabbath and keep God's way of life that it brings such joy and peace and happiness along with some trials too. But we need those trials to help us to build the character to qualify to rule this world kingdom that's coming with Jesus Christ. Now that's what God is going to give you to do if you choose to, or let Him choose you and obey Him in this age. That is what is going to happen in your life. This is good news. It's the greatest event ever to occur in the universe, the return of Jesus Christ to this earth. And He's going to smash that beast, totally smash it, and bring peace and joy to the earth and to the universe forever. Until next week, this is Gerald Flurry. Goodbye, friends.
Who or what is the beast of the apocalypse or book of Revelation chapters 13 and 17? What does Bible prophecy reveal about world events now leading to Armageddon and the end of this age? Herbert W. Armstrong's booklet, Who or What is the Prophetic Beast, unlocks these mysterious prophecies that will bring this world to its final end. This full-color illustrated booklet examines all the prophecies, charting which have been fulfilled already, and unveiling the future of this earth-shaking political system and how it will affect your life. You need this booklet, and you can receive it absolutely free. While requesting this booklet, you will also be given a free one-year subscription to our magazine, The Philadelphia Trumpet. The Trumpet is a magazine of understanding, answering critical questions about the world around you, tackling in-depth news analysis and significant social trends. It shows the causes and solutions to our global ills and gives invaluable insight on practical daily living. To request the literature offered on today's program, simply click on the Request menu option. The preceding program and all literature were produced and sponsored by the Philadelphia Church of God.